Welcome to Norfolk Perspective City Slice. I'm Bob Batcher, and I had an adventure the other day, and I wanted to bring my friend in to help share my adventure. Fraser Picard, how you doing?
Good.
Okay, all I know is that you are this magical guru. What is your real title over in IT?
I am officially called a GIS team supervisor.
And GIS stands for?
Geographic Information System.
I thought it was God, he meant everything or something like that. Okay, you are an award-winning GIS person.
Yes, for another application the team wrote called Storm.
Which is an application that we use during, guess what?
Storms.
But it's an application that can be used all the time, not just with storms.
Right, right. Any kind of emergency event where we want to track things and map them.
Okay, but we want to talk about the adventure that I go on every day, and that's right here on Norfolk.gov. I went online, and as we said in the media, we had a whole brand new site.
We do.
And it's really cool. And why did we head in that direction?
For a variety of reasons. This new site is much easier to maintain for the organization. Mm-hmm. We can update things quicker, and the content is more current and won't get outdated so quickly.
And it can also, we can be much more responsive to what's going on. Now, yes. we're on live.
Yes, we're
right
on
now.
Live.
Okay, venture on. I promised you in pre-tape, I'm not going to touch anything.
That would be good.
The reason I was on an adventure, I think I was on the phone with the help desk. So scroll down. It's really simple.
Yes.
And what I really want to focus on today, even though there's a whole bunch of features and you can really kind of play around a lot in here.
Yes.
If you want.
Yes, there's
is
a lot.
I want you to go to Norfolk Air.
Okay. Right down here on the bottom of the screen.
Now, the purpose for Norfolk Air really is for us to kind of identify maybe where we are in the city as to where we live.
Exactly.
Right?
And also, it's to bring lots of information about a property to one place. Instead of people having to go around and look at different pages or go to different websites, we're trying to bring it all into one website right here in Norfolk Air.
Okay, now here's the theory. Most people who are in the city know where they live.
Yes.
Right? So if they put their address in there.
Yes.
That's an address.
Okay.
Don't remember this address, guys. Nobody was watching this. Okay.
201.
Wait a minute. What happened?
What the system does is it automatically searches every address in the city of Norfolk that starts with 201. So that's okay. What it's doing. And the more you type, the shorter the list is going to get.
Cool.
Now, you do have to pick from the list.
Okay.
Okay.
Go to the last one then. How's
this
that?
This one?
That's an address that I should recognize.
Okay. Just remember, you must pick from the list. You can't just go ahead and type it in. You've got to pick from the list and then hit the go button or hit the enter key.
Hey, that's it.
You know this property?
Yeah, right there in the corner.
Okay. Now, some of our users may have been to the old Norfolk Air. This is the new version, so I wanted to go over some of the new features. Obviously, the main new feature is the map is now the entire screen, whereas before it was a little square in the corner of the website. Now it is a full screen mapping, so you can see things a lot clearer.
Okay, now I'm gonna test you, because later on you're going to test me. I recognize that as my house.
Yes.
But when do I do recycling?
Okay, let's go and find out. To find out,
you can do that from here?
You can find out a lot. I can tell you where the nearest library is or the closest park or anything like that.
So, cool. Did you know this stuff?
Not quite.
Oh, that's what that's
over
for.
Over here, that info tab, this will slide out. And you'll see we have information here. And to give you an idea, all the data behind here, every day we process approximately 850,000 records every day to populate the information you're seeing over here.
Holy moly. Okay.
So you want to find out about municipal services. So here,
that's where recycling
dates. Click here, and it'll tell you the next 3 days that you should put your can out for recycling. And you can also print that and put it on your fridge just to remind you.
Because what I'm discovering is this house doesn't have anybody in it, so I have to go all the way around the corner to find the other neighbor's blue cart. So this is much more efficient.
Also, you'll notice we've added contact information. If you need to call about recycling, we've added the phone number, or you can email them by clicking here.
So if I want to do bulk waste? How about bulk waste?
You can email them and set that all up. So, yes, everything here will allow you to do that.
Fraser, you're just telling me no excuses?
No excuses
anymore. Okay. Now, in the old days, I could get a picture of what that house looked like.
Right. Well, and let me point out something here. Some people may not know. Just by clicking on the info tab, you can make that go away, or okay. It'll come back out. It's not gone forever. Just know that.
You're reading my mind. You broke it.
Now, one other thing we've added is this new slider tool. And as you slide it, you can adjust how much of the photo you see or as much as the base map. So you can slide that back and forth.
Cool. Okay.
The other thing we've added is up here, you'll notice it says imagery year.
Right.
And this image here was flown recently, just in January.
Well, I was going to say, how do they get these pictures?
We have a contract with a company out of Rochester, New York called Pictometry, and they fly the city using Cessna planes with a special camera attached to the bottom of it, and they just fly back and forth over the city, capture it for us, and then splice all those images together into one, so we have an image of the entire city at once.
Cool.
And it is pretty high resolution. You can zoom in on this to a certain point and zoom out. You can look at your neighborhood, and I'm just using the scroll wheel on the mouse to do that.
Okay. Now, let me see. How about my Civic League meeting?
Your Civic League meeting. So let's go back here.
Okay.
As I mentioned, just quickly, here's the nearest.
See, I never knew to click on the info thing, so I never got into that. So I didn't have as much an adventure as I thought I was going to have.
You're going to have to play with it some
more.
This
is cool.
So if I click on Civic,
okay,
you will now see we've included where you should go vote, who your representatives are, and down here at the bottom, here's the Civic League information and when they meet. And you can also email them if the Civic League president has provided that information and email contact and all that. You can email the Civic League.
Now, this information is public information, so it's available.
Yes.
I was at a Civic League meeting, and there was some concern about a house on the street that there had been some code violations. They called into the call center, and they didn't believe that maybe we had triggered it. And we were able to go on. She found some kind of gizmo thing that showed.
Well, Bob, let's go see if you have any code violations.
Sounds good to me.
Let's start down there, okay? So here, you'll see there's
this
a link.
This is all behind that little info button.
All behind that info button,
this
there's
is
code
live
violations.
Okay. So the screen goes dark.
Well, I am glad to report that currently there are no active code enforcement cases on your property.
Because I just mowed my yard.
Good. And let's see if you have any historical ones.
Oh,
no historical ones, no cases. However, if there was one, you'd be able to click on that, find out when it was reported, how it was reported. Was it an inspector or was it someone who called it in? There's a lot of information and also the details. When the inspectors were out there, where that case is currently, if it's an open case.
Okay, cool. How about some of the city amenities, like a park? You said something about parks?
Yes. So we're gonna jump back to Civic. I'm sorry, Municipal Services.
Okay.
And here you'll notice we have the nearest recreational facility, its address, and the phone number to it.
6:30 every morning I'm at that fitness center. So that's right on the money.
And then the nearest park and the nearest library for you.
Oh, the Lafayette branch, okay.
Yeah. So now I will.
I go to Pretlow for mine.
It is based on not driving down a road. It's a kind of as the crow flies. In the future, we hope to have that ability to provide routing directions and things like that.
That is.
But, one of the other things I just wanted to jump to here very quickly is under the real estate data, we've added some more information. All the information you see here, although. Unfortunately, I gather you don't have a pool, a sauna, or a hot tub.
No, I really don't. I would tell you if I did.
We have added this information about each property.
I don't have a boathouse either.
Oh, well, maybe you could think about this side of the yard then. Anyway, this was really a request coming from the real estate market, real estate agents in the area saying they would like to have additional information about a property. And so that's what we're doing. Adding that here.
Well, you just mentioned something. We're kind of playing here and having some fun with it. Is that mainly how people are using it? I mean, is it mainly just Norfolk people looking at it?
Well, yes and no. We do track where our users come from. Obviously, right now, Virginia, we get the highest amount of hits, mm-hmm. and Norfolk. But we do have some interesting statistics. The second most popular state using this site is North Carolina. And
really?
In actuality, we've had visitors from every state in the United States visit our website and use it.
It is really a great way to kind of check out a neighborhood if you were going to be looking for a house.
Right, right. One of the big things we've added is this ability to overlay, for example, the zoning or the flood zone. FIRM stands for Flood Insurance Rate Map. And this has become very popular in finding out what zone you're in.
I was told I'm okay. Am I going to find out if I really am or not?
No, you are okay. It says X, low to moderate, so you're fine there. Also, just so you know, under the Public Safety tab, we do have this information on flood zone, and you can click here, and it'll give you details about the zone you're in. And if you want a description, you can click here. This goes to the FEMA website and gives you information about that.
And again, this is all from address base. You can get probably access to anything that you need in the city.
Yes.
Cool.
Any parcel of land in the city.
So what are the kind of gizmos they have showing? Okay, what are these guys up here?
Okay, I think they
call. Are those jewels? What are they called?
Icons.
Oh, icons. See, I have Microsoft 8 at home, and I'm still trying to figure out what a jewel is.
I'm sorry, but we're using an older one here. I'm going to hover over these. If you hover over an icon, it'll tell you what to do. So you can print out both the property map and the information on the side. I do want to note, by the end of this month, we are going to have version 2.1 out, and you'll be able to do a little more customized reporting. You'll be able to save to a PDF and things like that. Secondly, is this one to share a URL. If you copy and paste all this and put it in an email, the person, when they receive that email and clicks on it, it'll take them exactly to this property.
Cool. So. Awesome. Okay, let me go back to the front page then, because when we talked about codes.
Whoops. Jumped. There we go.
You say oops in front of the computer too?
Lots.
I thought that was just me. Okay, we're back at the front page. There's the request, because we talked about putting a request in. I mean, some of these you can do right from that site too.
Right.
But kind of in closing, the request tracker is really our Norfolk Cares Impact Center on steroids, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And this will allow you to submit a request to the city, whether it's a variety of different things or it's a code enforcement issue you want to report, all through this website right here.
And if go back to the front page again, because that's the only way how to get to it. I'm sure there's shortcuts. There is, you can do My Dashboard.
Right.
And all of this, you can kind of tailor-made the whole site just for what you want.
Just for you want. You will need to sign in, and then you can put what is most important to you on your dashboard and see it right there.
Did we cover everything?
Nowhere near it.
Wow. So the main thing to do is go on the adventure.
Yes. Go ahead. Try it out. There is a help document and also the ability to email us directly if you have any problems.
In fact, what I'd like to close with is we want to have you, the viewer, help us grow the website. So when you give the adventure, go on the trip through the website, and then give us a holler back on an email and say where we might be able to improve it, grow it, or a need that you might have. Thanks a lot, Frazier.
Thank you,
Bob. You're a gutsy man. Thanks for joining us.